morning. Welcome to worship. Beautiful Sunday morning, isn't it? Lovely sunshine, a little cooler, beautiful day. If you'd like to stand, we are going to join in singing Thy Word in honor of our special day today when we're presenting the Bibles to our third graders. So please stand as you're able and we'll join in singing Thy Word.
A lamp unto my feet and a light unto my path. Thy word is a lamp unto my feet and a light unto my path. When I feel afraid, think I've lost my way, still you're there right beside. Nothing will I fear, as long as you are near. Please be near me to the end. Thy word is a lamp unto my feet, and a light unto my path. Thy word is a lamp unto my feet, and a light unto my path. When I feel afraid, think I've lost my way, still you're there right beside me. Nothing will I fear, as long as you are near. Please be near me to the end. Thy word is a lamp unto my feet and a light unto my path. Thy word is a lamp unto my feet and a light unto my path. And the light unto my path.
Good morning. Please join me in the call to worship. Ever-present God, forever seeking and always teaching.
Open our minds to the truth.
Open our hearts to your grace-filled love.
Open our lips to share stories of faith.
Open our hands to create beauty, do justice, and show kindness.
Open our souls to the breath of your spirit.
Open our mouths to show bodily and loudly your praises. And please remain standing and join the praise hymn, Open the Eyes of My Heart, Lord.
Open the eyes of my heart, Lord. Open the eyes of my heart. I want to see you. I want to see you. Open the eyes of my heart, Lord. Open the eyes of my heart. I want to see you. I want to see you, to see you high and lifted up, shining in the light of your glory. Pour out your power and love as we sing, holy, holy, holy. Open the eyes of my heart, Lord. Open the eyes of my heart. I want to see you. And I want to see you. Open the eyes of my heart, Lord. Open the eyes of my heart. I want to see you. I want to see you. To see you high and lifted up, shining in the light of your glory. Pour out your power and love as we sing holy, holy, holy. To see you high and lifted up, shining in the light of your glory. Pour out your power and love as we sing holy, holy, holy. Holy, holy, holy. Holy, holy, holy. Holy, holy, holy. I want to see you. Holy, holy, holy. Holy, holy, holy.
You are
holy, holy, holy. I want to see you. Open the eyes of my heart, Lord. Open the eyes of my heart. I want to see you. I want to see you. I want to see you. I want to see you.
I do want to remind you, because I neglected to have it put in the bulletin, today is an assistant Sunday, and I also noticed I neglected to put the baskets up front, so we will get them up here, but at communion time, if you're called to give to that special offering to help people in need in the area, you can give that offering today. Let us join together in our morning prayer. Eternal God, we come to worship today with the realization that we need a sense of stability and rootedness in our lives. We are tossed about by conflicting beliefs. We deal with the stresses of managing our time and our resources. We must cope with other people and must deal with our own inadequacies. So we need to be rooted in you. We need something that will anchor us and give us stability. We need a sense of meaning which penetrates below the surface of things. That's why we are here this morning, to stay close to the source of our strength, our meaning, and our hope. Amen. Let us share our joys and our concerns with one another, please.
I just wanted to remind everybody we're going to have training for the candlelighters after service today. It shouldn't take very long, just a couple minutes of instruction
and
then opportunity for them to practice if they'd like.
Thank you, Sue.
Oh, and I just wanted to say, while the parents were listening, we are going to ask that candlelighters be here 10 minutes before the service starts, or someone else will probably light the candles for you.
Thank you.
I just got word that Dorothy Brandis will be going home from the Brookside Village Rehab Center on Wednesday of this week.
It's good news. Thank you for sharing that with us, Barb.
I have a couple things. Lisa's family needs your prayers. Her father is about to give up his battle with cancer. And Allie has been home this week with pneumonia.
We will keep Allie in our prayers and Lisa's father and family. Thank you. I just have a couple announcements. The Sunday school did start today. Our children's Sunday school started, so that's a good thing. And if you know of someone that you'd like to invite, please do so. It's at 9 o'clock. J- Just wanted you to know, too, that last week at our youth group, our 7th through 12th ecumenical group that meets on Wednesday evenings, we had 47. I think the week before I reported that we had 45, but it grew a little, so that's a good thing. If you would like to help prepare a meal, maybe once during the year, during the nine-month time or with the children, you could see Carol Wilson, talk to her about that. And also, I want you to know that today's the 7th, 2 weeks from today, on the 21st, when you come to worship, we will have your giving card, as we have done in the past, and other information in an envelope to give to you, to take home with you. And then we would ask that you would bring it back on October 7th, our first Sunday in October, Communion Sunday, and we will present them when we come forward to take communion, as we have done in the past. But, all that information will be in the letter, but I just wanted to kind of let you know ahead of time what we'd be doing. Also, the adult Sunday school starts today following worship, and this beginning of the year, it won't be the whole year because it's just about an eight-week-long series. This first one, Adam Hamilton is talking about the Bible. And I think Robin and Trevor have just a little clip. I just wanted you to hear what he said, Adam Hamilton. He's a pastor of an 8,000-member church. So we'll see if we can pull it up there, and you can just hear what he has to say about the Bible, since it is Bible Sunday, and about this study.
Hi, my name is Adam Hamilton, and I'm the author of Making Sense of the Bible. Over the next few weeks, we'll be reading this book together, and we'll be reading Making Sense of the Bible together. I wrote Making Sense of the Bible because as a pastor, I've had so many people come to me with earnest questions about Scripture, things that trouble them or disturb them, or maybe sometimes overly simple ways of understanding what the Scripture is that leads to trouble when they start reading and trying to interpret it. Now this week, we're going to start by talking about the nature of Scripture and how the Bible came to be with a particular focus on the books of the Old Testament. I love this book. I've read it many times. I read it every morning. I read it every night before I go to bed. But I still wrestle with it. And my prayer for you is that you'll love it too. That you'll read it, wrestle with it, learn to ask the hard questions that are raised by it, and ultimately that you'll be shaped by it every single day.
Thank you, Robin and Trevor. So that was just a little bit about what this study will be like. So I hope you can join us today following worship for that. Any other joys or concerns today? Let us bow our heads then for a time of silent prayer. Gracious God, we are thankful for this day you have blessed us with. Help us to use it to bring glory to you. We come before you today needing to hear your words of assurance. Assure us of your constant care for your creation. As the world sometimes seems to be out of control, remind us you are an all-powerful God who is still in control. Let the unrest in the world cause us to draw closer to you. Help us to seek your presence when we wake and all through our day. Forgive us, God, for the oftentimes weak faith that we have and how easily we can become distracted from our purpose as your disciples. Fill us with your Spirit, God, so we can be and do all you have asked of us. And we do again, God, as always, thank you for our many blessings in our lives, God. And we lift up to you prayers for Allie, God, for healing from her pneumonia, and we I think about Lisa and her father and all of the family, God. Just be with all of them and strengthen them and comfort them and then give them your peace even at this time. We continue to pray for Don and Dorothy and Aline and Roger and Kayla, Ruth and Jim and Craig, Anita and Carly. And we lift up to you all families who have lost loved ones, our soldiers and their families, all those in the nursing home and homebound. And we continue to pray for peace in the Middle East, God. We remember those who are being persecuted at this very moment for their faith, God. We ask your protection over them and strength for them, God. We just lift up those people in Africa that are being affected by Ebola, God, and we continue to pray for them that that a cure will be found, God, the disease will be stopped, God. We just pray that those that are able to send resources to help will do so. We lift all these saints up to you today, God, and again, we do trust in you and we love you, God, and we know that you're handling things, God. Sometimes it is just hard when we see what's going on around us sometimes. But help us to continue to trust in you and believe in you and have hope in you, God, because that's who we are as your people. We are children of hope. Pray all these things in your Son's name. Amen. The children come up, please. Morning. Morning. How's everybody today? Got more coming. Good. Isn't it a pretty day outside? You think it's a nice day? The sunshine, isn't it lovely?
It didn't start out that way.
It didn't. Was it cloudy this morning?
It was walking in with bare feet. I went inside screaming cold.
It would have been cold this morning. That's true. It's getting cooler. Well, good to see everybody. So we're going to play a little game. So you might want to spread out just a little so you're not, you know, so you're not bumping somebody when you move your arms or something, okay? All right. Well, you know what? And you've played this game lots of times, and I think we've even played it here, but we're going to play it again. Simon Says, okay? Are you good at it?
Yeah. I'm really good.
Okay. Well, here we go. Do you know, does everybody know what Simon Says is?
Yeah.
Okay.
Oh, that's what it is.
Okay. So Simon Says, put your hand on your nose. Take your hand off your nose. Oh, you're good. Simon Says, put your arm, your right arm up. Now wave your arm. Oh, Simon didn't say to wave your arm. Okay. Touch the top of your head. Oh, Simon didn't say. Okay, let's see. Simon said, touch your ear, either one. Now touch your other ear. Oh, you're doing good, right? Let's see. Simon says, wave to everybody out there. All right, that's enough waving. Oh, Simon says, stop waving. Okay, one more. Let's see. Simon says, nod your head up and down. Okay, Simon says, stop. All right, you were good. That was fun. Kind of fun, right?
Yeah.
All right. Well, the reason we played Simon Says is because we did what Simon said, right? Or we were trying to. But in life, there are certain people that you really should try to do what they say. Could you tell me somebody that you think you should probably try to do what they say? Who do you think, Kyler?
God,
right, God. And like your parents, right, that you trust and you know they love you. Yes, Eric.
Your mom.
Your mom, right. People that you know love you, you should do what they say. So what I want to talk about is doing what God says. So where do we learn about what God says to do?
Here.
In church, right? And where else can you go? Like when you go home, your parents can teach you. But like what if you're by yourself? How can you learn what God wants you to do if no one's teaching you? A Bible, right. Bible, and that's what I'm talking about today because it's Bible Sunday. So I want to tell you this real quick. In the Bible, there's a story about Jesus being tempted by Satan. Have you heard that story?
Yeah. He was food.
Right, he was without food and water, and he was really hungry. And Satan said, "Well, you know, if you're really the Son of God, you could take that stone over there and you could turn it to bread." Yeah, and then he asked him that. He told him, "Jump off that cliff up there. Let's see God catch you, because God would do that."
Jump off that cliff and you, I will do whatever you want.
Right. Mm-hmm. And Jesus said no because he knew those were things that God didn't want him to do. So he said no to Satan. I'm not going to do those things because I know my Father doesn't want me to. But you know what else Jesus said? He quoted scripture, meaning he had scripture memorized in his head, Bible verses like from the Old Testament. And Jesus said those words out loud to Satan to help him resist, to help him not do bad things. So that's why one reason why it's really good to read the Bible and learn it, because in the Bible it says that God can help you. How about if you're somewhere and you want to take something, you know, like maybe take a candy bar. Mom or dad said, I'm not buying that for you. You don't need any candy today, but you really, really want it. And you think, well, maybe I'll just take that. Nobody will notice. You know what? If you remember what God teaches us, what does God say about stealing? Shouldn't do it, right? So maybe that can help you. You can think, oh, I know what the Bible teaches. The Bible says, no. Or what about this? What if somebody hits you on the playground and they smack you and you're really upset and the first thing you want to do is just
hit him back?
Do you know what Jesus says in the Bible?
Don't do it.
So you might remember. Maybe that can come to mind and say, oh, but I know God says don't hit back. Okay, like that. Or forgive. Forgive, okay? So that's why the Bible's so important, because you can use it all through your life to help you do the right thing, make the right choices. That's why we're celebrating today that our third graders are getting their Bibles, because that's a wonderful thing. I have one of these, like I always do, and this is about the temptation of Jesus, what I was talking about. You are very good listeners. Do you think we could bow our heads and you can pray the words after me? Okay. Dear God.
Dear God.
I love you.
Help me
to remember that the Bible can help me always. Amen.
Amen.
Oh, very good. Wonderful. That one's yours. Okay. You're welcome. You're welcome. Thank you, guys. You don't want one? Okay. Would our third graders want to come forward now to receive your Bibles, please? And I know Allie Pearson would be receiving a Bible too, but she's home with her family since they're having sickness and family concerns right now, so she wasn't able to be with us this morning. So before Merlin, our lay leader, gives you your Bibles, I'm going to just read something, and then after he hands them to you, the congregation is going to pray for you for using the Bibles, okay? Are you ready? Okay. Receive the Word of God. Learn its stories and study its words. Its stories belong to us all, and these words speak to us all. They tell us who we are. They tell us that we belong to one another, for we are the people of God. I'm going to let Merlin give them to you, and then just stay up here, okay? Thank you, Merlin. Congregation, would you please join me in praying? We rejoice in this step in your journey with God. We pray God will guide you, your family, and us as you use this holy Bible in your home, in your church school classes, and in our worship. We will learn together and grow in our love for God's word. Thank you. And we're just going to clap, because we want to celebrate this special day in your life when you're receiving the Word of God. Thank you, Grady and Kyler and Aaron. Thank you for coming up. Thank you, Merlin. Also, if we have teachers here today that will be helping, youth group or just any teachers that will be teaching in our church this year, I won't even make you come up front. If you just want to stand where you're at, how would that be? If you just stand so we can recognize you and we have a blessing for you. Yeah. And if you just look around, we thank all these people for giving of their time. And we have others that are not able to be here today. But let us join in this blessing. Please join me. Thank you, Lord, for our church teachers. Pour out your blessings upon these your servants who are answering the call to be church teachers. Guide them in their work. Reward their faithfulness with the knowledge that through them your purposes are accomplished. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Thank you. And we do thank you. We really know how important it is that our young people hear the word of God, and we know they hear it at home, but it's important that they hear it from other people as well. So we thank you for giving of your time and energy to do that.
The scripture lesson this morning is from Psalms, verse 105, or chapter 105, verses 1 through 11. And I believe it's on page 718 in your pew Bibles. Give thanks to the Lord, proclaim his greatness, tell the nations what he has done. Sing praise to the Lord, tell the wonderful things he has done. Be glad that we belong to him, let all who worship him rejoice. Go to the Lord for help, and worship him continually. You descendants of Abraham, his servant, you descendants of Jacob, the man he chose, remember the miracles that God performed and the judgments he gave. The Lord is our God. His commands are for all the world. He will keep his covenant forever, his promises for 1,000 generations. He will keep the agreement he made with Abraham and his promise to Isaac. The Lord made a covenant with Jacob, one that will last forever. I will give you the land of Canaan, he said. It will be your own possession. Praise the Lord.
Please stand for the reading of the gospel lesson this morning from the Gospel of Matthew. This is Jesus speaking about his suffering and death. From that time on, Jesus began to say plainly to his disciples, I must go to Jerusalem and suffer much from the elders, the chief priests, and the teachers of the law. I will be put to death, but 3 days later I will be raised to life. Peter took him aside and began to rebuke him. God forbid it, Lord, he said. That must never happen to you. Jesus turned around and said to Peter, get away from me, Satan. You are an obstacle in my way because these thoughts of yours don't come from God, but from human nature. Then Jesus said to his disciples, if any of you want to come with me, you must forget yourself, carry your cross, and follow me. For if you want to save your own life, you will lose it. But if you lose your life for my sake, you will find it. Will you gain anything if you win the whole world but lose your life? Of course not. There is nothing you can give to regain your life. For the Son of Man is about to come in the glory of his Father with his angels, and then he will reward each one according to his deeds. I assure you that there are some here who will not die until they have seen the Son of Man come as King. This is God's good news. You remain standing as you're able. We will sing Wonderful Words of Life.
seated.
You have probably heard the phrase, good to know, right? And maybe sometimes you've said it yourself about something, good to know. Sometimes the phrase is used sarcastically, like in response to the following warning labels that people read, and then they said afterwards, good to know. I want to share some of these. These are actual warning labels. A Zippo lighter that warns users, do not ignite in face. Good to know. On the warning bottle of a bear of aspirin, do not take if allergic to aspirin. Good to know. Windex label cautions us, do not spray in eyes. Good to know. Mr. Bubble warns, not intended for human consumption. Good to know. And an RCA television remote control has a warning that reads, not dishwasher safe. Good to know. And the Harry Potter toy broom wants its buyers to know, this broom does not actually fly. Good to know. And the warning label on the Hershey almond bar reads, may contain traces of nuts. Good to know. You can find more of these painfully obvious warning labels at dumbwarnings.com if you're interested. And sometimes the good to know phrase is attached to interesting but really trivial information, like the following. A regulation golf ball has 336 dimples. Good to know. John Lennon's first girlfriend was named Thelma Pickles. Good to know. And you can burn 26 calories in a 1 minute kiss. A duck's quack doesn't echo, and no one knows why. Good to know. And Howdy Doody had 48 freckles. Good to know. Well, have you had enough good to knows? Yeah, well, good to know. I'm good to know. Good. Now, sometimes there is information that is actually good to know, like your purse is still on the roof of the car. Right? Good to know. Your pants are on backwards. Good to know. You are a woman and you just entered the men's restroom. Good to know. You are a man and you just entered the women's restroom. Good to know. And this one's really good to know. Your mic is still turned on. Good to know. Talking about information that is really good to know. We actually heard some information today that is really good to know. I'm referring to the scripture lesson from Psalm 125 that Craig shared with you and the lesson from the 16th chapter of Matthew that I share with you. Scripture is full of good to know truths. Psalm 105, verse 8, reminds us that God remembers the promises he has made to us and that God will keep his promises. God's precious promises are found throughout the Bible, through the Old and New Testament. Promises, like I want to just share a few with you, but just think about what good news these promises are. The daily forgiveness of sins when we confess. How good is that? The Father's continued presence wherever we go. God is always with us. The helper that Jesus promised, the indwelling of the presence of the Holy Spirit. The Lord's strength in whatever difficulty we face. God's provision for our daily needs. A way of escape when we are tempted. Wisdom for every challenge. Rest for our weary souls. Peace, regardless of the troubles we face. Fruitfulness as we grow older. That's good news. Guidance along the pathways of life. The absolute guarantee of God's love. Eternal security and heaven as our eternal home. Aren't those all good news? I think they're wonderful promises, wonderful good news, good to know. Jesus shared a sort of paradox with his disciples in today's gospel lesson. Jesus' words that you heard and saw on the screen, for if you want to save your own life, you will lose it. But if you lose your life for my sake, you will find it. It is a seemingly contradictory statement, yet it is very true. I have a book titled Real Life to the Extreme, Making Choices That Matter. the book is all about showing us that we have choices as to how we live our life. We can merely exist, or we can live life to the extreme. Living life to the extreme means that we have placed ourselves in God's hands for God to do what he wants with us, what he knows is best for us. Which really, although sometimes that can be scary, it's really more exciting and certainly more fulfilling than any life we could plan for ourselves. In order to experience this extreme life, we have to be willing to lose our own life, meaning the life of self-will. We have to be willing to give up our own agenda for our life, our list of what we want to do, in order to let God lead us and show us what he wants us to do, which again will be the abundant life that the Bible talks about in the Bible. We have to allow God to lead us. If we play it safe all the time, which I've done lots of times in my life and still do at times, and are unwilling to trust God and step out in faith with God, we lose out on that extreme life God wants for us. We have to be willing to put our whole selves into God's hand and trust him, and then he will do amazing things with us, things that we could never do on our own. I think that's really good to know. That's information that we need to remember. We need to know that and believe that, that when we place ourselves in God's hands, we will be amazed at what God can do with us. I found a song online titled Good to Know that I had never heard before, but it, I believe, is a beautiful song. It was sang by Francesca Battistelli. And so Robin and Trevor found it for me, and they're going to play it. And so I'm going to have this as the end of my message today.
I know it's been a while. I'm here again. And it won't be the last time I fall apart. But you won't let me get too far. You're speaking to my heart. It's good to know. It's good to feel the arms of grace. To know that my mistakes are covered by your love. It's good to know. It's good to see that you won't change. When it's said and done, you'll always be enough. To know. Yeah, there's so much more that I know I could be. So take my worries with you when you leave. There's hope that I am counting on, 'cause I'm never too far gone. It's good to know, it's good to feel the arms of grace. To know that my mistakes are covered by your love. To know that I can know.
And all God's children said, Amen. It is now time to take our offering, so I would ask the ushers to come forward, please. Please stand. Let us join in praying our prayer of dedication. We give you thanks and praise, God, because your love will endure forever. You have given us the gift of your salvation and have placed a deep joy within our hearts. We are more than blessed to be here in your presence. Amen. Thank you. Please be seated. And if you're using your hymnal, you can turn to page 12 for the invitation to our service of Holy Communion. Christ our Lord invites to his table all who love him, who earnestly repent of their sin and seek to live in peace with one another. Therefore, let us confess our sin before God and one another. Merciful God, we confess that we have not loved you with our whole heart. We have failed to be an obedient church. We have not done your will. We have broken your law. We have rebelled against your love. We have not loved our neighbors, and we have not heard the cry of the needy. Forgive us, we pray. Free us for joyful obedience through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Hear the good news. Christ died for us while we were yet sinners. That proves God's love toward us. In the name of Jesus Christ, you are forgiven.
In the name of Jesus Christ, you are forgiven.
Glory to God. Amen. And now we are at the great Thanksgiving. The Lord be with you.
And also with
you. Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is right and a good and joyful thing, always and everywhere, to give thanks to you, Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth. And so with your people on earth and all the company of heaven, we praise your name and join their unending hymn.
Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of power and might, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna.
Holy are you, and blessed is your Son, Jesus Christ. By the baptism of his suffering, death, and resurrection, you gave birth to your church, delivered us from slavery to sin and death, and made with us a new covenant by water and the Spirit. On the night in which he gave himself up for us, he took bread, broke the bread, gave it to his disciples, and said, "Take, eat, this is my body, which is given for you. Do this in remembrance of me." And when the supper was over, he took the cup, gave thanks to you, gave it to his disciples, and said, drink from this, all of you. This is my blood of the new covenant poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this as often as you drink it in remembrance of me. And so, in remembrance of these, your mighty acts in Jesus Christ, we offer ourselves in praise and thanksgiving as a holy and living sacrifice in union with Christ's offering for us as we proclaim the mystery of faith.
Christ has died. Christ is risen. Christ will come again.
Pour out your Holy Spirit on us gathered here and on these gifts of bread and wine. Make them be for us the body and blood of Christ, that we may be for the world the body of Christ, redeemed by his blood. By your Spirit, make us one with Christ, one with each other, and one in ministry to all the world until Christ comes in final victory and we all can feast together at his heavenly banquet. Through your Son, Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit, in your holy church, all honor and glory is yours, Almighty Father, now and forever. And now with the confidence of the children of God, let us pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom and the power and the glory forever. Amen. We have open communion. We invite all to come today, and we will be doing communion by intinction. We'll give you a piece of bread, and you can dip it in the juice. At this time, we are going to sing our communion hymn, an invitation to come to the table. As you're singing that, I would invite the communion stewards to come forward, please. Table is set, please come. Let us join in praying our prayer after receiving. Eternal God, we give you thanks for this holy mystery in which you have given yourself to us. Grant that we may go into the world in the strength of your Spirit to give ourselves for others. In the name of Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. If you would now stand as you're able, we're going to join in singing Standing on the Promises. Thank you for joining us for worship today. I invite you to stay for a time of fellowship and refreshments, and I do pray you have a blessed week. Go in peace. May the love of God, the grace of Jesus Christ, and the power of the Holy Spirit be with you today and remain with you for always. Amen.